Hi everyone, welcome to the next session of pre-stressed concrete, loss of pre-stress. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the loss of pre-stress due to elastic deformation, as well as we will see some problems. Before going to discussing about the problems, in previous session, we have discussed various type of short-term losses, as well as various type of long-term losses, that is nothing but time-dependent losses we have seen. In today's class, we will discuss about the total amount of losses according to tensioning systems, based on the pre-tensioning system or post-tensioning system, how the total loss it will be appeared for a different type of tensioning system, that we will discuss. And if you see here, the total pre-tensioning losses, it will be equal to the loss due to creep of concrete. It will be creep, it is the constant stress under sustained strain, and elastic shortening of the concrete. First one is the loss due to creep, as well as the elastic shortening. Next, as well as we are having shrinkage losses, and next one is the steel stress relaxation or stress in steel relaxation. These are the different type of total losses we have discussed. We are going to finalizing in the total pre-stress tensioning losses, in the loss of pre-stress under the total amount of losses. And coming to here, total loss of pre-stress due to post-tension, again we are seeing here, the total loss of pre-stress in the post-tension we are taking as the loss due to creep of concrete, as well as how the pre-stress concrete losses in the creep it will be happening. The same way we are calculating the total loss of pre-stress due to post-tension also. Next, we are calculating the elastic shortening of the concrete, again based on the elastic shortening. Based on the type of the concrete member you are taking, how much elastic shortening it will be happening, that also we are considering. And next one is the shrinkage of the concrete. Based on the shrinkage nature of the concrete also, we are calculating the total loss of stress in the steel, as well as total loss of pre-stress in the concrete. Steel relaxation, as well as anchorage slip plus friction losses also we are considering for the total loss of pre-stress in the post-tension members. These anchorage slip and friction losses will be adding for the pre-tension, which gives the losses of the post-tension pre-stressed concrete members. And coming to here, this total losses, it is difficult to generalize the amount of loss of pre-stress because it depends upon the so many factors. Directly you cannot say for this type of pre-tension member how this much is the amount of loss, or this type of pre-tension member this is the amount of loss. That loss directly you cannot say. And coming to here, the properties of concrete and the steel, it is depend upon the properties of concrete and the properties of the steel, the elastic properties, as well as the strength properties, tension properties, all these properties it will depend the loss of pre-stress. Next one is the curing and the moisture condition. How much amount of time you are giving for the curing of the material, based on the curing condition and moisture environmental condition also the loss of pre-stress it will may depend. And then next one is the magnitude and the time of application of pre-stress. After while preparing the pre-stress or post-stress concrete members, how much amount of pre-stressing force you are applying and how much amount of magnitude, that means how much quantity by using you are drawing that pre-stressing force, that also we are calculating by using this concept. Next, process of pre-stress. The process of pre-stress, already familiar you are with first chapter and second chapter, you have seen the manufacturing and process of the pre-stressed concrete, as well as the post-tension concrete members. And if you see here, methods of loss estimation, there are two methods that can be used to estimate the loss of pre-stress in concrete, is the lump sum approximations as well as refined estimations. Lump sum analysis is the usual method. It will be give the more calculation, more perspective view, or more accurate calculation of the values for the estimation. One should keep in mind that all estimates for pre-tension losses are just that estimations. What you are calculating, all these pre-stress losses we are calculating, just we are estimating, not it exactly applicable in the practical field condition. And if you come to here, lump sum estimation for loss of pre-stress is given by the first introduced by the American Concrete Institution, the American Society of Civil Engineering Committee, 423 in 1958. The American Association of Highway Authority Transportation Organization also will give the some conditions for the based on the how much total loss it will be happening for the grade of the pre-tensioned concrete, grade of the concrete. All these terms they are given, this type of the bar as well as post-tensioned strands are there, how much characteristic strength or tensile strength is there for both the concrete and the steel, they are manufactured and they are considered. And this American Association with LRFB specifications give us some basic requirements. Members that are post-tension must be non-segmental members with spans that less than the 160 feet and concrete stressed and age of 10 to 30 days. The members what you are preparing, it will be span less than 150 and 10 to 30 days which you have to prepare. Members that are pre-tension must be stressed at an age where the concrete strength is not less than 3000 pounds for square inch. While we are stretching these tension members, they must be stressed at an age of giving pre-stressing force of 3500 pounds per square inch. Members must be made from the normal weight concrete, not lightweight concrete or heavy weight concrete. The structural members cast by the pre-stressing members are post-tension members who are using the normal lightweight concrete. Members cannot be steam cured nor moist cured. Steam cured by even the thermoelectrical heat, we should not to prepare this type of the pre-tensioned concrete or post-tensioned concrete members. The pre-stressing steel must normal lower relaxation. The stress relaxation we are providing here, the low stress relaxation. Okay, and thumb rule for the loss of pre-stress we are having here based on the pre-stressing loss, we are having some basic relations. For average steel and concrete properties, the tabulated percentage may be taken as the representative of the average losses. And coming to here, pre-tensioning as well as post-tensioning members, the average loss of pre-stress are calculating as elastic sharpening and bending of concrete. For pre-tension we are taking it as 4% and post-tension we are taking it as 1%. As well as creep of concrete, we are taking the loss of pre-stress in pre-tension system as 6% and post-tension system as 5%. These are the rough estimates or thumb rules for the loss of pre-stress in the concrete, either in the pre-stress concrete or post-tension concrete. In coming lectures, coming videos, we will see the based on the properties of the materials, how much amount of loss of pre-stress due to all these shrinkage, creep and relaxation of stress in steel, will solve by calculating some suitable data. Next one, as well as we are having the shrinkage of the concrete. If you see here, shrinkage of the concrete in the pre-tensioning loss, we are getting it as 7%, whereas post-tension members, the loss due to shrinkage, we are getting as the 6%. Next is steel relaxation, that means stress in steel, we are getting it as 8% in terms of the pre-tensioning members and 8% also in terms of the post-tensioning members. And total loss of stress relaxation or total loss of stresses in steel and concrete, the total loss of pre-stress, it may be 25% in terms of the pre-tensioning structural members, and 20% loss of pre-stress it will may be happening in the post-tensioning members. These are the rough estimates or thumb rules for the loss of pre-stress in the concrete of post-tension and pre-tension structural members. Now we'll see the design or analyzed problem solving how the loss of pre-stress it will be happening. And coming to here, the first one is the loss due to elastic deformation of the concrete. The loss of pre-stress due to elastic pre-stress. That means due to elastic nature of the concrete or the elastic behavior of the steel, modulus of elastic of the steel, how the loss of pre-stress it will be happening, that we will discuss in today's in this class. And coming to here, loss of pre-stress equal to or loss of pre-stress it will be depend upon the modular ratio and the average stress in concrete at the level of steel. The loss of pre-stress, how the loss of pre-stress it will be happening on the either pre-tension members or post-tension member means, it will depend upon the modular ratio. Modular ratio here, this is the term is denoted by M. It is defined as the ratio of the modulus of elasticity of the steel to the modulus of elasticity of the concrete. Normally, we are having the modulus of elasticity of steel as 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square. The modulus of elasticity of concrete we are having 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square. The modulus of elasticity of the concrete we are taking based on the characteristics strength with respect to the grade of the concrete. What type of grade of concrete you are using based on the modulus of elasticity of concrete we may estimate. And if you see here, where FC is the pre-stress in concrete at the level of steel, pre-stress in concrete at the level of steel. That means while embedding the steel into the concrete, while we are stretching the stress in steel, in that stress in steel, it will transfer the stress to the concrete. And pre-stress in concrete at the level of steel, what amount of levels we are stretching or we are giving the pre-stressing for to the concrete, at that particular level the stress it will be happening in the concrete, that stress it will be called as the pre-stress in the concrete. That pre-stress in the concrete we are naming by the symbol as FC, where FC is the pre-stress in concrete will corresponding to the stress in a steel. And next coming to here, where ES is the modulus of elasticity of the steel, the modulus of elasticity of the steel. For a mild steel, high yield strength deformed bonds, high strength deformed bonds, we will calculate the modulus of elasticity of the steel. Normally the modulus of elastic steel we will take as 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square. And where EC is the, already I have mentioned, the modulus of elasticity of the concrete. The modulus of elasticity of concrete we are taking it as 57,000 square root of FCK based on IS 456 code book. Based on the characteristic compression strength of the concrete, the modulus of elasticity of the concrete we are estimating by using this formula. After this, we should have to calculate the stress in steel as well as strain in concrete corresponding to the modulus of elasticity of steel and modulus of elasticity of the concrete. The modulus ratio here we are by representing the symbol as alpha e, where alpha e is the notation for the modular ratio in terms of the pre-stressed concrete. This alpha e equal to modulus of elasticity of steel to the modulus of elasticity of concrete, which is nothing but the modular ratio. Next, corresponding to this modular ratio, we should have to find out the strain in concrete at the level of steel. Strain in concrete at the level of steel. That means how much pre-stress in concrete it will be available based on the how much modulus of elasticity of the steel. That means we are stretching with respect to the pre-stressing force, that will give the strain in concrete. That strain in concrete at the level of steel we are taking it as FC divided by EC, where FC is the pre-stress in concrete and EC is the modulus of elasticity of the concrete. Next, corresponding this stress in steel corresponding to this strain, that means nothing but stress in steel. Steel we are giving the stress corresponding to the strain. How much amount of pre-stressing force are giving to the concrete, that will generate the strain. Based on that strain, how much stress in steel is generating, that we should have to calculate. That stress in steel equal to nothing but FC divided by EC into ES, where FC is the stress in steel and EC is the modulus of elasticity of the concrete and ES is the modulus of elasticity of the steel. For this loss of stress in steel we are taking, finally it is as alpha E into FC. That means based on this elastic loss of deformation, how much amount of loss of pressure due to elastic deformation happening, it will be depend upon stress in concrete at the level of steel with respect to the modular ratio alpha E. This is the concept for loss of pressure due to elastic deformation. Based on this concept, we will solve the one basic problem, how the actual field conditions with given size of the beam or given area of the steel wires, how much loss it will be happening, that we will discuss. And coming to here, this is the problem. The problem is a pre-tension concrete beam of rectangular cross section 150 mm wide and 300 mm deep is pre-stressed by 8 high tensile wires of 7 mm diameter, located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. If the wires are tensioned to stress of 1100 newton per mm square, calculate the percentage loss of stress due to elastic deformation. Assuming the modulus of elasticity of the concrete and the modulus of elasticity of the steel, they are given in the problem as 31.5 into 210 newton per mm square. And if you, while writing this type of problem, first you should have to write the all given data. Of that, you have to solve the problem. And coming to here, a pre-tension concrete beam of rectangular cross section 150 mm wide and 300 mm D. First, I will write the given data. The given data they are given in the problem as width of the beam B equal to 150 mm. This is the width of the beam and total depth of the beam they are mentioned in the problem as 300 mm. This is the B is the width and D is the depth of the beam. Based on this area of the concrete beam, we can solve that. That means B into D, which will give the area of the concrete cross section. Is pre-stressed by the 8 high tensile wires of 7 mm diameter. That means here area of the steel also we can calculate. That area of the steel is nothing but 8 into pi by 4 into 7 mm diameter square wires we are having. 8 into pi by 4 into d square, if you substitute, you will get the 307.9 something mm square. That is the area of the steel wire. Next, after that, located, this pre-stress wires are located at 100 mm from the soffit of the beam. Suppose this is your concrete rectangular beam. From this concrete rectangular beam with soffit is nothing but the bottom of the beam. From this bottom of the beam, we have provided 7 mm diameter of 8 high tensile steel wires. After they are asking us to calculate the percentage loss of stress due to elastic deformation. After they given the modulus of elasticity of the concrete, EC equal to 31.5 into Newton per mm square, as well as modulus of elasticity of the steel, they are giving as ES equal to 210 Newton per mm square. 210 Newton per mm square. These are the parameters given in this problem. For this problem, you should have to calculate the data. And coming to here, after that, first we are calculating some basic steps. In that basic steps, first we are having the area of 8 steel wires. That means area of the steel wires we are giving it as 8 steel wires we are having. Area of the steel, normally we are having the formula AST equal to n into pi by 4 into diameter square. Here we are having number of bars as 8. Pi by 4 into d square is the area of the single steel wire. For 8 steel wires with the 7 mm diameter, we are having area as 308 mm square. Next, pre-stressing force P equal to, already you know the basic formula. The basic formula is nothing but stress equal to resisting force per unit area or force per area. From this we can calculate the force also. The force is nothing but P equal to sigma into A, where this A is the area of the pre-stress wires or area of the steel wires, and the sigma is the stress in steel. The stress in steel they are mentioned in the problem as 1100 Newton per mm square. Hence why pre-stressing force P equal to stress in steel into area of the steel wires as AP. That means 1100 into AP, 8 into pi by 4 into d square. We are getting the pre-stressing force for this concrete beam with 150 mm, 300 mm depth as 338.8 into 10 power 3 newton. So while stretching the steel wires with 338.8 into 10 power 3 newtons, you will get the pre-stressing force in the concrete with the applied steel wires. After that, we are calculating the area of the concrete section. The area of the concrete section we are taking as A equal to, area of the concrete section A equal to B into D. That means width of the section into depth of the section, 150 into 300. Nothing but we are getting it as 45 into 10 power 3 mm square. Area of the concrete section we are getting it as 45 into 10 power 3 mm square. Next, we are calculating the second moment of area. That second moment of area is nothing but we are having the formula BDQ by 12. Moment of inertia nothing but we are having the formula as BDQ by 12, where B is the width of the section, D is the total depth of the cross section of the structural member. By calculating the moment of inertia, second moment of area, BDQ by 12, nothing but we are having 33.75 into 10 power 7 mm4. This is the second moment of area of the concrete cross section. After that, we have to calculate the modular ratio of the structural member. The modular ratio is nothing but the stress in steel to the corresponding stress in concrete. Modular ratio alpha E equal to stress in steel ES divided by stress in concrete EC. That equal to 210 divided by 31.5, which we are getting the modular ratio alpha E as 6.66. Modular ratio alpha you are getting as 6.66 or 6.67 we are getting the modular ratio. After calculating this modular ratio, the next step is we should have to calculate the stress in concrete at the level of steel. Stress in concrete at the level of steel. By giving this much amount of pre-stressing force, how much amount of stress in concrete is generating, that we should have to calculate. That stress in concrete at the level of steel FC equal to P by A plus PE into E divided by I. Or PE nothing but the moment equal to M by section modulus, M by I by Y. Based on that also we can calculate this formula. That stress in concrete FC equal to P by A plus PE into E divided by I, where E is the, since it's from this orbit, we are taking it as a half, that PE into E divided by I, where I is the second moment of area of the concrete cross section. From this, the stress in concrete at this level of the steel equal to P by A, where P is the pre-stressing force we are getting as the stress into area of the steel was 338.8 into 10 power 3 divided by 45 into 10 power 3. Plus, again, we are having the pre-stressing force into eccentricity, we are taking it as from the soft of the beam, we are taking it as half. And 338.8 into 10 power 3 into 50 into 50 divided by, where 33.75 into 10 power 7 is the second moment of area of the cross section of the concrete beam. From this, we are calculating the loss of stress due to elastic deformation. The final step, we are having the loss of stress due to elastic deformation. The loss of stress due to elastic deformation, we are taking this value as alpha E into Fc. Loss of stress due to elastic deformation of concrete, we are taking it as alpha E into Fc, where alpha E is the modular ratio of the concrete, that is nothing but S by Ec, and Fc is the stress in concrete, that is nothing but P by A plus PE into E divided by I. By substituting those values, we are getting the loss of the stresses due to elastic deformation as 66.73 newton per mm square, 66.7 newton per mm square. This is the loss of stress due to elastic deformation we are getting from this structural member. Next, we are having the percentage loss of stress in steel. This percentage loss of stress in steel equal to how much amount of loss of stress due to elastic deformation is getting, in that if you get reduced this total stress in steel, you will get the percentage loss of stress in steel. The percentage loss of stress in steel, we are getting it as 66.73 into 100 divided by 1100, which it will give the 6.06% of loss of stress in the steel. This is the formula how we are calculating the loss of stress in the pre-stressed concrete member due to elastic deformation. Like this, in the same way, we are having the loss of stress due to shrinkage, loss of stress due to creep, loss of stress due to relaxation of stress in steel, friction loss, anchoring slip. In some problems, they will mention, they will give the some concrete member like this, and they will ask us to calculate the total losses for this type of the structural members. In subsequent lectures, we will based on the concept of the loading condition, how the loss of pressure it will be happening for the structural members, that we will discuss in the subsequent lectures. Up to now, this is the concept for the loss of pressure due to elastic deformation. Thank you.